So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to bring your models directly into Blender via Speckle. Now, this is a really great workflow intended for architectural visualization or just visualization in general, where you have to kind of collaborate with other people who are authoring their models in different software to you. So this will be a really fast and efficient way to get that model into Blender and vice versa. So for this tutorial, we're going to assume a couple of things. The first is that you already have a Speckle account set up and ready to go. The second is that you have Rhino and Blender installed on your computer. And the third is that you have the Rhino and Blender Speckle connectors installed on your computer as well. Now, if you don't have any of the Speckle things that I listed, you can easily go to speckle.systems and get started from there. Okay, so we just need to get our Rhino file published onto Speckle. So how do we do that? Well, all you have to do is go over to the Speckle panel here. If you don't have this window available, you can just go and type in Speckle into the command bar and hit enter, and that window should pop up for you. So all we need to do is go down to the publish button here and click that. So a new window is going to come up, and at the moment I'm currently in the culture workspace. So it's going to ask you, hey, which project do you want to upload this model to? And actually we're going to create a new project for this model. So to do that, we're just going to go over and click create new project. A little window is going to come up and ask you what the name is. We're going to say this is Rhino to Blender. So we're just going to create that project. And then it's going to ask you what you want to name your model. So we're going to say Rhino model. And then we're just going to hit create Rhino model. Now it wants to know what parts of the model do you actually want to publish to Speckle. And for this demo, we just want to publish everything. So we're just going to go ahead and hit Control A to select everything. And it's going to give you some facts about how many objects you're actually publishing to Speckle. And if you're all happy with that, we can all go ahead and click publish. So that's going to go ahead and convert all of that geometry into Speckle geometry. And it's going to take a little while to process that and upload that onto the Speckle servers. So you can see now that that model has been published to Speckle and it's come up with a new message, and you can actually go directly to your model from the Speckle panel. So let's click on view and there you go. You can see that your Rhino model has been published onto Speckle. This is a really great space for collaboration. If you want to send your model to clients or to your colleagues, they can actually click around the model and even comment and upload PDFs to those comments. It's really, really cool. So now that we have our model up on Speckle, we can actually bring this back down to Blender. So let's go ahead and do that now. Okay, so we're in Blender now. And we have a fairly familiar site, if you're familiar with Blender. We have the default cube, the camera, and the lamp. So we just want to start off with a clean canvas. So we're just going to hit A to select everything, and then delete to delete everything. Now, if you hit N, you'll open the N tab. And you can see over here that we have Speckle installed. Now, if you don't see Speckle here immediately, and you've installed the Speckle Blender connector, we can just go over to Edit, go down to Preferences, and then if we bring the window over and then come down to Add-ons and search for Speckle, this may not be ticked. So if it's not, just go ahead and tick it, and that will install the Blender Speckle add-on into Blender. So you can see a very familiar site here. We have a publish and a load button available to you. So for this project, we just want to bring that model into Blender. So how do we do that? Well, we click the load button. That's going to highlight a new option for you. And all it's going to be asking for is how to select your project. So select that button and a new window will come up. You can see that it is already signed into my account. We are in the culture workspace, and we have a couple of projects that we've already created. So we're just going to go and click into the new Revit project to Blender, click OK, and we're going to select a model. So we're just going to select Blender model for this use case and then click OK. So a few more options are going to come up. By default, you will be loading in the latest Speckle model, but you can choose which specific version you actually want to load into Blender. But for this test, we're just going to go and load the latest version. So we're just going to be OK. So the final option is to load that model into Blender. So let's go ahead and click that. Now an option dialog box will pop up and it will give you two options. This is the collection instances or linked duplicates. So to illustrate this point a little bit more about the differences between linked duplicates and collection instances, I've brought in two models using those two settings. So these are actually blocks that are coming in from Rhino. So instances, blocks, they're essentially the same thing, but in Rhino, they're called blocks. So we've brought these blocks in from Rhino in two different ways. So one is using the linked duplicates method, and the other is using the collection instances. So we can see what that looks like and how they differ. So with the collection instances, you can see that the collections themselves are instanced. So what this means, and the advantage of that, is that this is a lot cleaner when it comes into Blender. It's less messy. The disadvantage here is that you can't edit these instanced collections, not necessarily easily. There's some plugins that maybe you could use to do this, but just in vanilla Blender, it's a little bit harder. So the alternative is bringing these blocks in as linked duplicates. So if we expand this collection, you can see these blocks or instances have been flattened and they've become linked duplicates. So these are individual objects now instead of being instanced collections. The advantage of these is that if we go into edit mode and just hit G, you can see if we move the geometry around, we can see that this geometry is linked. So one edit edits all of the geometries. And so this is just an easier way to getting access to those instances. The disadvantage here is obviously you end up with a lot of geometry in your collection. So you'll just have to choose which one you sort of prefer. If you feel like you are going to be editing the instances, then you probably go with a linked duplicate. Otherwise, if you're not touching that geometry, just go with collection instances because it will be neater when it comes into Blender. So the connectors that can publish instances are currently Rhino, SketchUp, AutoCAD, and Civil 3D. And we're currently working on Revit to get that up and running for you. So anyway, that was a bit of a tangent. Let's get back to loading our model into Blender. So let's go ahead and click OK. So there we are. We can see our model has been successfully loaded into Blender. So a really nice feature of bringing your Speckle models into Blender is that they preserve the materials that you've applied in your previous modeling software. So in this example, this model has actually originated from Revit, and those materials have been brought in into Blender. But in a lot of cases, because you're bringing your model into Blender, it's probably because you're doing an ArcViz sort of workflow. So because of this, we actually have a really nice feature with the Blender Speckle plugin. And what this is that materials that you apply to your model will stick around through updates. So when you bring in an updated version of your model, the material overrides that you placed on your new model will stick around between versions, which is really cool. So we can demonstrate that really quickly just to make sure I'm explaining it well. So what we want to do is actually replace this timber texture we have here with a nice concrete texture that we have. So to do that, we can go over to the shading tab. So we already have that mesh highlighted. So because I have the Node Wrangler plugin installed, all I have to do is click on the principled BSDF node and hit Control-Shift-T. And that will bring up a new window and asking us for the PBR material. So here it's actually come into a grass material. Actually, I want to use the asphalt material. So let's highlight that entire material and click this button here. That will automatically bring in the material, and you can see that that's been applied to our model. So this is the magic bit. If we go back into our layout, you can see that that hasn't been changed here, but if we go into the rendered view, we can see that that material has been applied to our model. So if you change the version of the model that's actually loaded into Blender, that material will stick around. So we can do that by clicking on this button here, and it'll ask us if we want to load a specific version. So now you can see that we have a new version actually uploaded. So we want to update our model. So let's click on that. Click OK, and that's going to load that model into Blender, and we'll see that that material has actually stuck around for this new loaded model. Okay, there we are. Our new model has loaded, and our material override has successfully stuck around. So we added this as a feature so that it will be really easy for you to continually get updates on your model, but not completely lose all the progress you made overriding the materials in Blender. So this is a really useful feature if you're bringing your models into Blender for the purposes of rendering. Obviously, you're probably going to override most of your materials with nice PBR materials. So this is just a way to make that process easier for you and to allow you to keep getting updates as you go. So our Blender Speckle connector is in active development, and we're looking for any kind of feedback on the certain types of workflows that you're looking to do with this connector. So if you're interested in using Speckle for Blender, we're really happy to hear from you and any ideas you might have to improve the plugin. We also have a really amazing active community that we're more than happy for you to participate in. So if you have any ideas or any feedback, we're happy to receive it. That's all from me. So happy speckling!